Hi, I'm Spencer with the Tennis Warehouse Racket Review. This is the Head UTEC Speed Innegra 16x19. The latest racket in the UTEC Speed line uses Innegra technology for increased shock absorption. This racket features a 27.2-inch length, a 100-square-inch head size, 11.6-ounce strung weight, and a 6-point headlight balance. Let's check in with our playtesters to see what they thought. We're here with Susie. Susie, what did you think of this 16x19 version of the Speed Innegra racket, and how did it work for your power game?
It was a little different from my power game. Normally I'm really aggressive on the baseline player, and I had to change up my game a little bit. I really liked the slice and the angles I got with this racket, and I was placing the ball really well. Power-wise, I didn't think this was a powerful racket. My balls were a little bit shorter, especially on the baseline. At the net, though, I really liked the racket. I thought the racket was very maneuverable. My drop shot angles were really good. The serve I liked a lot too, because I got a lot of kick off the ball, which is a little bit different than how I normally play. And then the overhead was really powerful as well. It's a little bit stiffer racket, so I really recommend it for someone who wants a stiff racket with a lot of good angle and touch.
We're here with Jason Huang. Jay, how did this racket work for your great baseline game?
Yeah, you know, I thought it was pretty decent. I definitely had to get used to it. I had to get used to the extra length. I felt a little sluggish at first, so I really had to focus in on my timing and preparation. But once I got used to that, I thought hitting shots in the sweet spot was great. I got a lot of power, a lot of depth, and a lot of spin on it. Downfall really was outside of the sweet spot. I felt there was a noticeable drop in power and targeting. Unlike Susie, I thought, for me, I really liked hitting shots down the line. I really couldn't pull off the angles as well. But yeah, I thought it was a decent racket. You know, we tested the 18x20 earlier, and for me, that's the type of racket I prefer over the 16x19.
Any string preferences on this one?
Yeah, surprisingly, I liked a full bed of multi. You know, I'm a poly player, but because it was kind of low power, I preferred a full set of multi for this racket.
We're here with Kana. Kana, what did you think of this latest version of the Innegra racket?
Like Jay, it was pretty decent. It took a while to adjust to. I noticed from the previous version that it is a little bit stiffer, so I think I did like the previous version a little bit better. But you know, it opened up a lot when I switched it to a multi-filament. It is low powered, because the first time I hit with it was with a poly. And I definitely felt I was losing a lot of depth on my shots. So actually, when I slowed up my swing, I got a little more depth on the serves. I was struggling with it on the first serve, but on the second serve, since it is a 16x19, I could really feel that I can pop it up and get a little more kick on it. But overall, you know, I had a great time, and it's definitely for the player who is looking for a stiffer racket.
We're here with Ryan. Ryan, how did the 16x19 pattern work for you?
I thought it was great. I liked this racket a lot overall. I picked it up and it was really easy to use right away. I felt in control from the baseline all the time, and I also really enjoyed it at net. I hit with more of a flat shot, but I was able to get pretty good spin off of slices. I got some pretty wicked slices and angles. And another nice thing I liked about it was that head normally has the more rectangular grip shape, and this one did not seem to have quite as pronounced a rectangle, so that was a big plus for me. Overall, a good addition, I think, to the headline.
Well, you've heard it from our playtesters. That wraps it up for this edition of the Racket Review. Check us out at tenniswarehouse.com for further information. Thanks for joining us.